Rachel again, and I mispronounced her name from the stage a second time. I admit my errors. Up next, Mike Naig, running again, running for the first time, although he is currently in the office, for Agriculture Secretary.
Well, thank you very much, and wow. It is a tremendous honor to serve as your Secretary of Agriculture and also to be able to welcome you to the Iowa State Fair. And as we say, nothing compares to the Iowa State Fair. You know, God made Iowa for agriculture. You can see it when you travel this great state. You can see it in how productive we are. You can see it in our people. And this fair represents that great agriculture and those people all across this state. So really, think about it this way. This is the Super Bowl, or this is the state championship for a lot of young people who have worked very hard throughout the last year to bring a project from an idea to fruition, or to bring a livestock project to the fair. And so when you see a young 4-H'er or FFA member walking around these grounds, you look, there we got a couple shirts over here, you look at them and think about them competing in their state championship and their Super Bowl. So we're just thrilled to see that all throughout the grounds. As I said, you know, God made Iowa for agriculture, but we cannot take any of that for granted. We are a tremendously productive state. You look at our statistics in the areas that we lead in, corn and soybean and pork and egg and biodiesel and ethanol. But again, we cannot take that leadership position for granted. We have to always be advocating and working to make sure that we bring certainty to our farmers and to our businesses, and make sure that we can have that bright future for agriculture that we know that we need in this state. So my background, I'm originally from Northwest Iowa. Anybody know where Cylinder is in Northwest Iowa? We got a couple people here. The white knuckle curve on Highway 18. If you don't make the corner, you're gonna hit the bank. You know where I'm talking about. So straight north of that curve is where our family farm is. My great grandfather purchased that farm in 1902. And I had the tremendous experience of growing up, like a lot of kids in the 80s, corn and soybean and hog farm. And my siblings and I grew up watching a community that struggled, frankly, and watching our family and our neighbors struggle through a difficult time in agriculture. My dad would say that the only thing that he could control was how hard he worked and how many hours he worked in the day. And we saw that throughout all across Iowa. And we're experiencing some uncertainty and some challenging times across the state here today as well. And it's a reminder that we've got to continue to advocate for our farmers and businesses. My wife is from Southwest Iowa, Malvern in Mills County, and we've got three little boys, 11, 9, and 4, and they keep us hopping, as you can imagine, back and forth to baseball fields and things like that, but we're very, very blessed to have those boys keeping us hopping around. I mentioned we have a century farm in our family, 1902. One of the things that I'm absolutely looking forward to, I know my predecessor, Bill Northey, considered it one of the highlights of his year, was to award the Century and Heritage Farm Awards, and we'll do that Thursday of this week. And so a Century Farm is a farm that's been in someone's family for 100 years. A Heritage Farm is 150 years. Think of what a family has to have overcome, the challenges that they have to have managed through to have a family, have a farm, stay in their family for that many years. And it is a tremendous honor to be able to recognize those folks as they cross the stage on Thursday in the pavilion. You know, again, we've got to make sure that if we're going to have the bright future that we want to have in this state for agriculture, we need to make sure that we're advocating for our farmers and businesses. Just yesterday, we were able to host the acting administrator of EPA, Andrew Wheeler, out here on the fairgrounds. We thought it was a great sign that he was here to meet with us, to have a round table with about 30 of Iowa producers here directly from farmers. We appreciate the fact that he was here. I tell you what, I know he left. He had no mystery in his mind about where Iowa farmers stood on things like Waters of the United States and overreach, overregulation from EPA, or where we stood on the renewable fuels standard, and I'll talk about that in a second. We also had Greg Dowd, Chief Ag Negotiator for U.S. Trade Rep's Office, out here in Iowa in June. Again, a chance to engage directly with, bring those folks out, have them engage directly with our Iowa farmers and hear directly what their concerns are. We'll continue to do that. It's critically important that we continue continue to advocate. So the big picture, the big things that I'm thinking about, making sure that we have markets for Iowa products, both international and domestic. We've heard a lot about international trade and some of the uncertainty right now with trade relationships. There is no doubt that we need to hold our trading partners accountable, but there is also no doubt that Iowa farmers are experiencing the brunt of the retaliatory effort and tariffs against the United States. We must see action on trade. We need trade, not aid. That is what we hear as I travel the state, and we'll continue to push for that. Domestic markets. We need to have a strong and growing renewable fuels sector in this state. Let's remember what was all of why we got into renewable fuels to begin with. We wanted a U.S. Produced renewable source of energy. We wanted something that was good for the environment, good for jobs, good for our communities, good for consumers. Now, that's what we have in the renewable fuels policy in this country, and we need to continue to push for certainty and year-round access to higher blends of ethanol. The second piece, if Iowa's economy is based on agriculture and our agriculture is built on our natural resources, then we've got to stay laser focused on improving our soil health and improving our water quality. We are 5 years into implementing Iowa's nutrient reduction strategy, and very proud of the work that's been done over the last 5 years. But we've got a lot of work to do. What we are trying to accomplish here in the state, and we're a leader in the United States in this effort. We are trying to build a culture of conservation, not a culture of regulation. And that takes working together with farmers and landowners across our state. We are laser focused on that. We will continue to move ahead, again, if we want to achieve that future that we know is possible. And the final piece, and I hear this everywhere I go, and it's all about the need to attract and retain young people, particularly young people, in ag careers. And whether I'm on a farm or whether I'm in an ag business, where the folks are struggling to find employees, and so we need to retain the folks that are in our communities, connect earlier and help them understand the kind of high-tech, high-pay jobs that are available out there, but also attract into agriculture and into the state of Iowa the kind of workforce that we need. So, with that, again, just a tremendous honor to serve as your Secretary of Agriculture. One of the best parts about my job is that I am involved directly here in the State Fair. By statute, the Secretary of Ag is on the State Fair Board, and so I get a chance to really see how this place works. It takes thousands of people who care deeply about their particular event or their particular competition. Isn't that so Iowa, to put it all in and to make this whole fair work that way? Absolutely. And the other thing, I will say it, I've got the best job. I get to travel somewhere in this state almost every day, except for these days during the fair where we'll be right here. But I get to travel somewhere in the state almost every single day. And what I see out there and the people I meet inspire me and make me believe that our best days truly are ahead. I wish you all could meet the people that I meet every day as I'm traveling this great state. But again, thank you. It's a tremendous honor to serve as your secretary. I would very much appreciate your vote and your support in November. And also, it was a pleasure to be here with my friends Jeremy Davis, Paul Pate, and Mary Mosman, and thank them for their service as well. So thanks again. Enjoy the fair.